morning, ladies and gentlemen. Chalk One here on my Let's Play channel, looking at, yep, you guessed it, Hello Car, your truck simulator 2. It's been a while since we had one of these videos, actually, but I have been driving. I've been driving lots. I've been driving in my new Volvo FH16 truck, and I've been having a lot of fun with it, actually. And as you can see in the wheel cam, the wheel has gotten an overhaul as well. I don't know if I mentioned this before yet, but I bit the bucket. Bit the bucket? That's not even a term, is it? I went out and dropped the cash on a Logitech G27 setup. So nice. Having an actual stick shift, a clutch, and all that. And I'm not a clutch, I'm not a manual car transmission kind of driver in real life. So I hadn't made a video in a while because I wanted to get at least a little bit more comfortable with this before I started making a fool of myself in my videos. This trip is actually already underway. I had started it yesterday. I wanted to do a video today, and I didn't really want to cancel it because, for one, you can't throw away beer. We have a really lovely trailer. The Tuborg Dark, genuine dark beer. I love myself some dark beer. And never actually tried this one. I might go to the liquor store later and see if they have that there. Give it a shot. As you can see, I've got one of the Halloween skins on my truck. I think this one looks badass, actually. So we are... If we look at our nav system, if we look at our menu map, world map, we're on our way from somewhere up in the ProMod era. We are going all the way down to the very southeastern end, to Kosice in the Czech Republic. I believe that is the Czech Republic, or Slovakia, one of the two, I can't remember. In any case, we're taking beer there, and it's very important, so we clearly can't just... abandon that load. So, figured, you know what, we'll just start halfway through. We'll just give it a shot. We just had a rest, had a little nap. Let's get this puppy on the road. It was raining last night, hence the wipers are still on. I think we got the... Nope, parking brake is not engaged. Let's see where it takes us. So you'll probably hear me shifting quite a bit, and you'll probably hear me occasionally miss a gear. Or not so much miss the gear, as what I tend to do more. Come on, guy, go. I tend to not hit the clutch quite right, so that we end up revving the engine a little bit more than we should. But, hey. It's just a virtual truck, right? And I pay for all the damage to my transmission. It's my company, after all, so it's not like I'm wrecking somebody else's property. Shoot, I just realized we're going to be having a little bit of night driving here. Oh well, we'll see how far we go before we get sleepy and then maybe sleep throughout the night. We do have lots of fuel, 1,200 kilometers worth of gas, diesel rather, in the tank. But this is a long trip, so this will definitely be a multi-part video. But I've been itching to get one out here, because I've been playing this game a lot. Look at the scenery. For those that missed it, I have installed a autumn mod pack, or a fall. It's actually called Herbst, which is the German word for fall, or autumn. It basically changes all the trees. As you can see here to the right, they make it look more like trees look like in the fall, which I thought was really, really cool. There's also a snow mod that I'm going to be installing at some point, I'm sure. Oh boy, we're going to get stuck in one of these intersections, huh? Yeah, this is great. Oh my god, the guy backed up! Did you see that? He backed up. I have never seen an AI car backup. I wonder if that's something new that they've added with the recent patch. This is... the most recent version now, 1.7. 1.7. But all that supposedly did was add the new Volvo truck that we're driving here. So, but I have never seen a car back up. Maybe that's a sign of things to come. So as we wait, what's been going on with everybody? We're now in the month of November. It is starting to... You know what? The trees in this game look a lot like the trees out my window as I look up. used that lovely air horn, lovely sound. It's like, why don't they go? I think we're gonna have to sneak past them, because they're just gonna sit there. Might as well take advantage while we can. Come on, buddy, let me over. There we go. Oh, I didn't realize we'd be driving these country side roads here. Oh well. Get the lights on. So Halloween is over. Battlefield 4 is out. Euro Truck Simulator 1.7 is out. Halloween skins. Pro mod is installed. There's so many exciting things happening. I've been watching a lot of Squirrel's videos. I've been going back through a lot of his old videos. If you don't know who Squirrel is, his YouTube channel is The Squirrel's Nuts. And he does a lot of sim type games. Train Simulator, Euro Truck Simulator, of course. He's probably the biggest Euro Truck Simulator YouTube/streamer out there. And it's, I think, how a lot of us found out about this game, probably. In any case, I've been going back to some of his older videos and watching some of his live streams with where he interviewed the CEO of SCS Software, who make this game. So it's quite interesting. Quite interesting to go back. It really makes me want to play this game even more. Oh, we're going to a city. But why is there a Oh, we're going on a ferry. Ah. Forgot about that. We are still in Sweden, I believe. What, that car just disappear? Yep. It just disappeared. We're leaving Gadsden. And the last time I actually live streamed some Euro Truck Simulator 2. And that was a lot of fun. And I went to a ferry terminal and I got completely stuck. I don't know, I just couldn't find my way onto the ferry. Wrecked a truck for 30,000 euros with damage. And luckily, I disconnected the trailer. This still seems to be about the easiest way to get on the ferry ever. It's just us, nobody else. Bounce! Just us on this ferry. Alright, well, we'll take that. Let's see where we can go. Only can go one way, to Rostock. So, we definitely need the lights on. Park and brake off. I actually should, I keep forgetting to shut off the engine. When I go on these ferry rides, you don't have to, because it just, you know, spawns you up again on the other side with the engine that's running, but just for extra realism, I should start turning it off. So we are in Rostock now. We have a long way to go, and it is dark now, unfortunately. So, as you can see, we're having our morning coffee. It is Saturday morning right now when I'm recording. Love playing this game on a weekend morning with a coffee. Even my coffee's gone cold now, unfortunately. So if you look at my cash total in the game right now, 1.2 million, that's not really, that, you know, that is a lot, but it's not, I don't want to say it's been done through cheating. Part of this trailer mod, trailer pack, what's going on here? Part of this trailer pack, the beer trailer one, which I love because the trailers look really cool, dude. Fucker. No respect. I'm in the roundabout. You have to wait getting in. Anyways, these beer trailers are much more valuable, as I'm sure any beer drinker would agree with me. Much more valuable than dried milk or something like that. So you actually get a lot more money for delivering these. I don't really consider that... it's not really cheating. I don't know. I mean, I don't mind so much because I'm still doing the trips. I just get a little bit more money for it. And to be honest, when you can't play the game that much, You know, I don't get to play it as much as I'd like to. New trucks and all that stuff are expensive, so I don't mind having things be sped up a little bit due to making more money from deliveries like this, so I don't feel too bad about it. And it actually seems to translate into my other employees as well. They seem to pull these loads every once in a while, and because I've noticed that a lot of their daily income dollars went up as well, so that's actually kind of nice. I do have two garages, a small and a large, 8 drivers, including myself, I believe. I think that counts myself. So the trucking empire is in full swing. Excuse me. In fact, I think at our destination we may purchase another garage, expand some more, because we have some of this money to burn. Oh, sorry, buddy. Go in the fast lane if you want to get past me. I mean, that is the whole point, right? Expanding, making more money to buy better trucks. I mean, this Volvo right now is decked out to the max specs that I can upgrade it to based on my rank, which is 19, I think. I know that there's some more upgrades being unlocked at 21. So we'll get there soon. But it's just been a lot of fun playing this. You know what? This wheel, I talked about this before. The wheel that I had before had a very small turning radius, and you know, of course, it only had paddle shifters. These guys back here, which all in itself, you know what, is not so bad. Believe me, it does make the game a lot more fun to play with that wheel than without a wheel of any sort. But should I go over? I should. But there's no denying that the G27 here is worth its money. It is much less plasticky, it's much more solid. Simple things like the mechanism that is used to mount it to my desk, it's a lot easier to quickly remove and reattach. It's a lot less cumbersome, there's a lot less, you know, I'm gonna stick my hand under there and then turn that this way and blah blah blah. It's really nice, it's got these knobs on top here that that you just tighten. So it's a really nice system, definitely worth the money. And of course, the fact that I now have an actual transmission, not transmission, but I actually have a gearbox, makes this game so much more enjoyable, actually. Challenging more, yes, a little bit, but, you know, when it comes to a game like Euro Truck, and people wonder why you're playing it, it is clearly for the simulation value that, you know, you want this to be as realistic as possible, because that is the appeal of the game. If it's not realistic, then, you know, I mean, you wouldn't pick up Grand Theft Auto 5, just jump into a truck there and drive around doing pretend deliveries. You know, you might do that for a little bit, but after a while, you're just going to run over pedestrians, because that's the appeal of that game. I do play Grand Theft Auto 5, by the way. I enjoy it, and I enjoy running over the occasional, ooh, pedestrian. I was just going to comment on how I haven't done this in a while with this new wheel, but I just did it. Went up on two wheels a little bit. Steering is a lot easier, though, with this wheel. It's a lot more precise. It's a lot less jerky. Feels like you're more in control of it. And the fact that the wheel in the game turns much more in sync with the actual wheel, physical wheel, is an extra bonus. Now, I don't want to be driving a lot at night here, so we're actually going to check in a minute here once we get onto a straight section to see. Let's take a look at our job specs here to see if we can allow ourselves an extra rest to make the sun come up again. It is currently Friday at 2200 hours. We are delivering oranges. Nudge, nudge, it's actually beer. We have 37 hours remaining on the delivery. So that's our deadline. It is going to take us 15 hours. So we have actually, I don't know why we're slowing down so much here. We actually have like a 12-hour buffer. Every time you rest is 6 hours, which means we should be able to do 2 more rests, which means we do have a spare because we need to rest in 9 hours. So we're actually going to turn off here into this rest stop. And just so we don't have to drive through the night too much. Night driving is scary, especially in these parts of the woods. Oh, this is not one of my favorite parking lots. I like the ones that have the extra parking lanes over to the right, because in this one I'm never... Are we meant to go around the back? No, we're not. Okay. But we do have to go all the way over here. See if we can squeeze behind this. Oh boy, this is gonna be tight. I don't even know if there's room here. Is this parking lot full? Oh god, it is. Ah, shit. Seriously? There's probably a spot over there. That's what I meant. I'm missing a gear. There's a spot right here, I left. You know what? We're getting some practice navigating this truck in tight spaces with the trailer. Can't always hit the right spot right away. This must happen to real truckers. You come in here and a lot of these parking lots are meant for trucks to overnight on, but are not always just the perfect size, you know? So, is this a spot? It's gotta be a spot, right? Come on now. There we go. Engine off, parking brake on, and snooze. There we go. Much better. You'll not need high beams anymore. Parking brake off. Is there a mirror? We got room here? I think we do. Can we squeeze though? You betcha. And away we go. So, Battlefield 4 officially released now on all the platforms. I don't know how many of you are Battlefield players. I am one of the many, many Battlefield players out there. Sorry, buddy. Sorry, buddy. You're gonna let me in. You're not gonna let me in. Wow. The douche. Come on. Anyways. Battlefield 4 is out. It's not as spectacular. Well, I shouldn't say that. It is actually quite the beautiful game. On PC, on consoles. I've played it on the Xbox 360, so I got distracted by my phone. I know I shouldn't be texting and driving, or Skyping and driving, for that matter. So, yeah, Battlefield 4, it looks amazing on the PC, no doubt about that. It does have its fair share of issues, though, at launch. However, I'm sure they're going to fix that, but there are some issues. It's not the smoothest launch of any Battlefield game I've ever been a part of, that is for sure. It's a bit rocky, especially on the consoles. Like, people are having all sorts of problems trying to get into games with their friends, and consoles freezing up, and on PC, the servers crash a lot, and, you know, you're in the game, and all of a sudden everybody gets booted out, which is really frustrating, because you've built up, you know, so you build up a good round, you got your points up where you want them, you unlocked a couple of gadgets and shit like that, and boom, server goes down. These are the kind of things that people expect from a beta in a game, and I think I don't know about everybody else, but from what I can tell on Twitter, there's quite a few disappointed people. I am quite disappointed. Let me just slow down, there's some weird shit going on back here. Because this could have been better. I seem to recall the Battlefield 3 launch being much, much smoother than that. Maybe I'm wrong about that, but maybe I just have a fuzzy memory. But it just goes to show that when you're releasing a game such as Battlefield 4, which is so huge, so complex, problems are bound to be happening, and there is a lot of them, though, but I don't know. It does eat a bit into your actual enjoyment of the game at the moment, I won't lie. I'm glad to have a game such as Euro Truck Simulator, because sometimes you just, you know, we've talked about multiplayer and how much we'd like to have that in here, but the kind of multiplayer that I want for Euro Truck is similar to the idea that the CEO of SCS Software actually has for this game, and it's sort of a social layer on top where, you know, you can have companies with your friends that work in them, different positions in the company, and that kind of stuff. That's the kind of integration I want. I don't know if I would, you know, I wouldn't mind playing in the same game with my friends, but I don't think I would want necessarily to, you know, I wouldn't want all these cars here to be driven by other people. I really wouldn't, because that comes with so many technical challenges, which is really evident by games like Battlefield. And you know, this game is nice because you can kind of rely on it. You know what I mean? If the day is not going so well, maybe the internet's crapped out again. Servers are crashing in Battlefield. You've lost all your stats. You're kind of annoyed. You know what? You fire this game up. You sit down, put your hands on the wheel, grab a coffee or a beer or whatever you have here, and just chill. You just drive around. Maybe you get and put some good music on, or even get into a Skype call with a couple of friends if the internet's still working, and just relax, you know? Yes, you have to focus on the road. Can't totally relax, but for the most part, you know, it is certainly a lot more relaxing than playing a first-person shooter, because I can just lean back. Ugh. Got it at 12th gear. I could even turn the cruise control on if I wanted to. And just enjoy the scenery. I don't know. There's definitely something about this game that makes it more relaxing. And I bet you there's a lot of other games that are similar to this that have the same kind of effect on people. Some games are more demanding than others on your focus and on your attention. And I don't think you can really ever rage in this game. I mean, you can get upset at the AI, sure. Pardon me. And there was one time where I got so stuck that I was quite upset because I couldn't, and I had to crash into people, you know, and you don't want to do that, but that's all you can do at that moment. So that's a little bit frustrating, but it's not the end of the world, you know. I don't think I've ever heard anybody rage too much about this game, whereas I certainly have heard plenty of high quality raging in first person shooters. I mean, that comes with the territory, and I've heard people complain about how frustrating it is, and I get so pissed off and stuff. It's like, well, you know, people always say it's just a game, bro, but more so than that, it's just a game that you're choosing to play, right? So if you play a game, and by the end of it, you are more upset, you're more pissed off, you've had a horrible day, part of that's on you, man, because you chose to put that game into your console, or you chose to launch that game instead of some of the other ones. And yeah, and you know, we don't ever start a game, we don't ever launch a game with the intention of getting upset. Clearly nobody does that. Everybody wants to have a good time or a relaxing time or something. But nobody is making you continue to play when you're upset. You know what I mean? If you're having shitty games and you're not enjoying it, please, man, just turn it off. Try a different game. If that other game has to be some sort of, I don't know, strategy game or simulation or shoot, some sort of Candy Crush type Marble Bash game, something that you can enjoy, then do that, right? I mean, nobody's gonna look at you poorly for quitting on a night of Battlefield because you're not having fun with it. I don't think anybody really enjoys playing with people who are so upset they're not having any fun in the game, because that kind of stuff transfers. Oh, look, another Volvo. So that's just my advice for people who play games and get upset with them. Whoa, why what's with these turns? Jesus. I don't want to go up on how many wheels would it be in the trailer? 7 wheels on one side? I don't want to do that again. Too scary. Too scary. Yes, rumble strips. Rumble strips galore. Somebody just messaged me saying, don't crash. I need to stop telling people when I record this game because they'd like to bug me. No, it's all fun. That is the one thing about this game. It is very hard to multitask in anything else. Yes, I could pause it every once in a while. And, you know, I do that when if I am not recording. But when you're recording, I don't want to be hopping over to the map screen all the time. Getting gear. Just so that I can answer a tweet or a message. That wouldn't be very much fun to watch. So we also gave away a bunch of copies of this game. Like 2 weekends ago now? Oh, time flies. 2 weekends ago, we had a try stream. We're going to be doing that again. Definitely. It was myself and Jammin and Rebel. We all got on our trucking seats behind the wheel, turned on our live streams, made a little website that you guys could watch all three of them on at the same time. I think that was quite enjoyable. Gave away a few copies of Euro Truck Simulator 2, including one of them included the Going East DLC as well. So we've expanded the Euro Trucking family by at least three people, which I think is great to hear. And I know that Jamie also gave away one game on his Facebook page. I believe I just heard him say in his last video that contest is over now, and he's awarded that to some lucky person. So I don't know what it is, but this game is, sometimes it's so affordable that it almost makes me want to buy a couple extra Steam keys just to give them away, because I enjoy this game so much I want to share it with you guys. And I'm happy every time that I see somebody tweet or say in the comments that, yeah, they tried out this game. There is a free demo, by the way, so if you want to give that a shot, you know, it's always nice to see when other people are enjoying this game and to hear their stories about it. Now, I mean, I will say that I've only tried playing this game with a mouse and keyboard once or twice in between when I was too lazy to hook up the wheel and stuff like that, if I just needed to drive from like the garage to the paint shop or whatever. But, so I mean, I will definitely say that having a wheel is not a requirement, but I would almost say that probably having a gamepad is a requirement, because you can play it with a gamepad, and from what I've heard is that is better than just a mouse and keyboard even. I don't know, I never tried it with a gamepad. I've tried it with a mouse and keyboard, and it, you could probably get used to it, but it's, you know, it's almost like playing a flight simulator with a mouse and keyboard and not a joystick. Now, there's different degrees, of course. Some people will play a flight simulator with not just a joystick, but an actual joystick and rudder and paddles and pedals and all sorts of things that I don't even know the names of, but throttle, yaw, there's hundreds of dollars worth of flight instrumentation that one can buy that some people definitely do. Because again, it heightens the enjoyment of that game, it heightens the immersiveness, it's all part of that. So we got 10 hours left to go on this trip. I don't think we're going to stop here. Whoa. I don't understand how sometimes you just run into this... speed limit's gone down. I wonder why. Ah, we're getting to a border crossing. I see. This may actually be a good place to end this episode, because we're at almost 30 minutes. So why don't we do that? I like parking at these border crossings. I think it's cool. There's also nice spots here for us to park in. So we're going to pull over here. We're not going to sleep. We're going to have a sandwich and a quick rest stop here is what we're going to do. And we're going to be back with you guys. Let's take a quick look at the outside of the truck. See, there's another trailer mod, but I like the look of this. I like the look of this truck and this trailer, and actually, you know, I should have pulled back, actually. Let's do that real quick. I know this is kind of silly, but let's go into reverse here for a second. Let's see if we can pull that straight from this angle, just to get a nicer screenshot for the thumbnail. You know, you guys can find me not only on YouTube, but also on Twitter and Facebook. Links to both of those are always in the description, of course. There we go. Now we got ourselves a nice angle. Look, we can take ourselves a nice thumbnail screenshot, right, with the flags in the back. In fact, I think if we go to the photo mode, the photo studio, we'll be able to do that even nicer. I do like this addition because with the other angle, I can't go and zoom out as much. I want to get those flags in the background while still maintaining the beer. The beer logo's there. See, now we're talking. Now we're getting somewhere. Starting to look like a thumbnail to me. Because we got stuff in the top there. There we go. See, now that's something. If we play with this, can we get the flags in focus? There. Ta-da! Until next episode, we'll continue from here. We'll talk some more about your truck simulator. See you again soon. Thanks for watching.